In his short career, Nick Drake sold only a few thousand records and played a handful of concerts. Today, his music has fans around the world. I'm Brad Pitt, and I'm a huge admirer of this English singer-songwriter, who's influenced artists from R.E.M. and Radiohead to Nora Jones.
When the day is done, down to earth then sinks the sun, along with everything that was lost and won. When the day is done, when the day is done, hope so much your race will all be run. Then you find you jumped the gun, have to go back where you began. When the day is done, when the night is...
But his musical reputation continues to grow and grow. Here's the man who signed Nick, legendary producer Joe Boyd.
There have been maybe one or two instances in my life where I've given a record or directed someone to listen to Nick Drake, and they've come back and said, yeah, it's nice, it's okay. Maybe one or two. Every other time, people come back and they say, wow, that's amazing. You listen to Nick Drake, and you become a convert.
Fame is but a fruit tree, so very unsound. It can never flourish till its stalk is in the ground. So men of fame can never find a way till time has flown. Far from their dying day,
you can almost see him willfully setting this whole thing up. God knows why. Why would a young man of 19, with the whole future ahead of him, write a song like Fruit Tree? Fame can never flourish till your stalk is in the ground. I mean, it's extraordinary.
Fruit tree, fruit tree, no one knows you but the rain in the air. Don't you worry, they'll stand and stare when you're gone. Open your eyes to another year. They'll all know that you were here when you're gone.
In this program, I'll be going in search of Nick Drake, the musician and songwriter, and Nick Drake, the person. I'll be playing lots of his music, including a newly discovered track that was his final studio recording. And I'll also be talking to those people who knew him best. Let's start with his recording engineer, John Wood, and first, Joe Boyd.
John and I have both been very fortunate, and our paths have crossed some great musicians, and I don't want to sort of start putting them in 1 through 5 order, you know. But certainly, I can't remember ever having, you know, very rarely have I had more fun in the studio than working with Nick. And there are very few records that I can listen to with as much pleasure, you know, all those many years later that I worked on as the ones I worked on with Nick.
He was very easy to work with because he just sat down and did it. And he sang and he played always at the same time. He played with great skill and control. And the guitar sound he made was extraordinary. We had several instances that other people would come to Sound Techniques because they wanted the Nick Drake guitar sound, and invariably, of course, would never get it because it wasn't anything that we did, it was something that he did.
He was always interested in music. There was music going on in the family the whole time. We were all into music in a very big way, and Nick, as a little tiny child of about 1, would get up and be conducting away. Every time any music started on, Nick would stand and conduct. And we always used to say he's going to be a famous conductor. Really, from then on, I mean, it was music the whole time. It was just the main part of his life, I think.
Nick's late mother, Molly Drake. Nick's story starts a world away from that of most rock and pop stars, in Burma. His parents met there, married, and stayed on. Then in the early 50s, the Drakes returned to England and settled in Shakespeare country, near Stratford-upon-Avon. Nick's sister, Gabrielle.
Now, I can never remember a time when my mum wasn't playing a new song of hers on the piano. But I think it's probably easy to see where Nick got his talent from.
To begin with, I started teaching him the piano, which was fairly disastrous, but we plugged on, and then he went to school and had some proper lessons. And it was one of the proudest days of my life when he said to me, "Oh, Mum, I'm glad you made me go on, because now it's my favourite thing."
Do you curse where you come from? Do you swear in the night? Would it mean much to you if I treat you right? Do you like what you're doing? Would you do it some more? Or will you stop once and wonder what you're doing it for? Hey, slow Jane, makes sense. Slow, slow Jane, cross the fence.
At the age of 13, Nick went away to Marlborough, one of England's leading fee-paying schools. He sang in the choir and played clarinet and saxophone. But it was the guitar that really captured his imagination.
I came across the chap who taught him the guitar at Marlborough. And he said it was absolutely sickening because, you know, after 6 months or so, Nick not only knew everything that he could teach him, but far outstripped him in playing as well.
One of the reasons those records sound as good as they do is because you had this guitar as the spine of all those mixes. I mean, that was the absolute centerpiece. Even if it wasn't the loudest or most prominent thing in some of the mixes, it was the thing that defined where everything else sat. And it was just so strong and so clean and so regular and so, I don't know, it's just, yeah, I think he was an absolutely extraordinary guitar player.
Strange face with your eyes, so pale and sincere, underneath you know well, you have nothing to fear, for the dreams that came to you when so young.
That musical talent quickly began to develop. In 1967, at the dawn of the Summer of Love, Nick was 18 and traveling around Europe and North Africa with a few friends when he stumbled across the Rolling Stones in Marrakesh. In a letter to his parents, he wrote, "We saw the Stones eating in a small restaurant, and Bob, displaying once more his nerve, marched in and told them I wanted to play the guitar for them. Surprisingly enough, they accepted this time, so I went in and did them a few numbers. We in fact got quite chatty with them, and it was quite interesting learning all the inside stories." You're listening to Lost Boy, In Search of Nick Drake, with me, Brad Pitt.